Hello, everybody. I'm Drew Tyrion. This is my partner, Dominic Santabria, and we're in store for a great one tonight. We have our 6-8 Howland Tigers going up against the 3-11 Austin Town Fitch Falcons.
Thank you, Drew. Welcome to our beach-themed varsity high school basketball game here at Howland High School. Both teams coming off close games. Howland just suffered a close loss to the Canfield Cardinals, while Fitch just beat Lakeside 50-49. Fitch started off 0-9, with their first meeting defeating Howland, is now 3-5 in their last game.
Howland has been great recently. They faced one of the best teams in the AAC conference in Canfield and gave them a great matchup. It was back and forth to the very end, only losing by 3 points. It was tied in the fourth quarter. I mean, you can't ask for much more than that. Of course, you'd want the win, but other than that, it's been great for the Tigers. They've had two big wins before that as well. They were able to beat the Lakeside Dragons, who were also Austin Town's last win on Tuesday, and the Harding Raiders. That was the biggest win Allen's had in forever, so they're going to look to keep it rolling here against Fitch.
Yes, the Harding game was great, winning off a game winner from our own player, Cameron Durick. Yes. Hope to see a great game here tonight, too.
Yeah, definitely hoping to keep it going.
Yes. And we will see you guys later for the pregame warm-ups and the national anthem.
All right, and we're back. Let's get into the starting lineups for the Howland Tigers, coached by Dan Bubon. The Tigers are starting sophomore Jordan Sperling, senior Frankie Manios, senior Nathan Barrett, junior Justin Jones, and junior Cameron Durick.
I'm expecting to see a lot of Nathan Barrett today, and especially Joey Vitale just scored 11 points off the bench for the Tigers. He's the best sixth man any team can ask for.
Oh, no doubt. He is a spark plug the second he comes off the bench.
Him, Justin Jones, and Nathan Barrett are... Nathan Barrett actually is now averaging 15.8 points per game and just scored 24 versus Canfield.
He has been a dominant big man. Anytime he catches in the post, it's 2 points waiting to happen. No doubt about it.
Howland's bigs, Barrett and Jones, are a master at the high-low. I've seen him score countless amount of times off that same play, getting points in the paint.
Barrett's gotten the whole team involved recently. Every time he catches in the paint, he's looking to kick out the shooters and go score for himself.
Barrett is truly having a monster season. I can't wait to see how he finishes it all.
And for Austin Town, coached by Brian Beattie, they have Lorenzo Russo, Todd Simons, Tommy Laskoffek, Devin Cheney, and Nate Laskoffek.
Speaking of Todd Simons, he's averaging 16 points as a sophomore right now for Fitch, currently leading them in scoring.
Yeah, he's definitely one of the best players in the county. He can go out and score at any given point. The Tigers are really going to need to lock up on him.
Yeah, and it's crazy to think he still has 2 more years left to play some high school basketball.
Yeah, he can only get better from here.
Howland sophomores have some games too. I'm hoping to see a big game from Jordan Sperling, who is starting over Gage Tonka tonight.
All right, let's look through the keys to the game tonight. For the Tigers, again, you've always got to look to play through Barrett. When he gets it in the post, he can score by himself and get others involved. Next, they got to protect the basketball. Turnovers have been the Achilles heel for the Tigers. Can't have those tonight.
Turnovers.
Finally, keep the momentum going. You've played 3 of your best games all year. Let's make it 4. And for Fitch, you've got to execute your offense. Get easy buckets, hit the 3, swing the ball around. Take away the bigs. Howland's 3 best players, their 3 best scorers, really, have been Jones, Vitale, and Barrett. Stop them from scoring. And finally, play some hard-nosed defense. You can never go wrong with playing some tough-as-nails defense, and they're going to look to do that tonight.
Yes, and playing through Barrett is key, because if they double-team Barrett when he's trying to score, like you said, he will kick it out and find someone open for a three.
Especially someone like Frankie Maas, who has been on fire recently.
Frankie Buckets, as we call him. Great shooter.
Also, Cam Durek, who's been shooting almost 40% on the year.
That's fantastic
at the high school level.
Yes, Cam hit the game winner and scored 24 against Warren G. Harding the other game.
All right, guys, we're going to get right back to you after this short commercial break.
Howland Local Schools, that means something to us.
It means we are coming together for a common goal.
A proud past.
A roaring future.
It means that we are all one.
Volunteering for a good cause.
Helping my fellow students.
It means supporting one another.
Doing our part to help the community.
Working alongside colleagues.
We're all one school, no one better than the other.
We want our schools to be the place where our kids receive a great public education. We embrace the pride of our past and continue to strategically create and foster their future through innovative practices with an open and sustained vision. Howland's strong sense of pride in the community and our commitment to academia and the arts is unparalleled. Our classrooms are built on pride and tradition. Nothing beats public education, and there's no better place to be educated than Howland Local Schools.
All right, we're back just after that short break through the national anthem. About to start introductions here tonight.
I'm very excited to see this matchup. Fitch is a Division I school, though Howland has been able to compete with them in the past, though.
I think Howland's really their biggest key tonight is they want some revenge.
They do.
They went to Fitch and they just came out flat. And Fitch took it to them. They wanted their first win of the year and they got it. But that's not going to happen tonight. They're going to come out way stronger. These past three games have just been a sign of how the season's been progressing for the Tigers. They've just developed more and more each and every game.
They're getting better and better. You know, they're committing less turnovers. They're playing faster. You know, you can tell they're getting stronger. You know, and there's nothing worse than giving a team their first win of the year. You know, that's the worst feeling.
Pretty small lineup out there for Fitch. 2 5'8" players in the starting lineup. You don't see that too often.
Yeah, our lineup, because Jordan Sperling and Cameron Durek. Sperling is a little under, I got maybe 5'6", 5'7", and Cameron Durek is just right around 6', if I'm correct.
Yeah, they have Sperling's listed at 5'8", and Durek is listed at 6', so you got that.
Sperling is a sophomore, so I think watching him play, he's very crafty with the ball. I don't think his youth is going to mess him up this game. I think he knows what he's doing.
No, I don't think so either.
Fitch does have 6'5", Stevie Woodbury, who I'm guessing is going to be guarding Barrett at center.
Yeah. When he gets in there.
Almost underway here.
Correction to the starting lineups. Number 11, Ruben Taley is in for Fitch. And he is making the lineup even smaller out there. He's only 5'6".
I think with the lineup being small, like we talked about, Barrett Battalion zones, we're going to have to use them wisely, take advantage of their size in the paint. And here we are for tip-off.
And we're underway as Fitch wins the tip.
Looks like Howland's going to go with a man-to-man defense to start the game off.
Going to download a big man.
And first basket of the game for Fitch is in.
Tommy Liskovic.
Howland takes it down. Pass to Jones. Out to Durek on the wing. Back to Sperling. And Durek's going to shoot that. He's open. And that's in.
That's a big three to start the game for the Tigers. Get that offense going.
Cameron Durg is a shooter. If you leave him open, he will take it and he will make it.
Oh, no doubt about it. Fitch now trying to set up their offense. They're running a similar flex offense to the Tigers.
Shots up and in.
Yeah, a little down screen action for Simons. Can't let him get him going early. He's most of their offense this year.
Yes, at 16 points a game as only a sophomore, he's going to be a very dominant player in the future.
Tigers swinging around. Manios open for three.
And, oh.
Off the mark.
That's all right.
Over the back call on Nathan Merritt. Going the other way.
Frankie Manios did have his struggles in the beginning of the year, but he's really coming back, going, I think, 5 for 5 for 3 against Harding.
Yes.
He's starting to get his stroke back.
He's been on fire recently. But for Nathan Barrett, you can't pick up fouls like that. If you're getting boxed out, don't go over the back of this Kovac. Just give up the board.
Yes.
The board.
Let
go the other one.
The worst thing could happen is late in the game, it's a close game, and Barrett gets fouled out. He's a key part of the team.
Oh, he's most of their offense. Reuben Taylor getting the offense going now. Swings over to Simons.
Stop
and that's a moving screen. It's going the other way, Tiger ball. 6:33 here. Tigers looking to take the lead back on this possession.
Bear will inbound into Sperling. Takes it up. Pass it to Manios at the top of the key.
Durg running open across the baseline. He gets the ball and now they'll quickly swing it around the key.
Durg shoots another three.
No good, but good look there for Durg.
Hey, if he gets that look, he'll shoot it every time. And I got confidence that he'll make it most of the time.
Chris Brown driving, but he takes a charge. Great play by Justin
play.
Jones.
Put his body on the line. Obviously, he's scared to do that with that mask he's wearing today.
Oh, yeah. That is a great team play right there. Anytime you go and try to take a charge, you can't get mad at your player, even when the block's called.
Yeah, because anyone who's willing to put their body on the line and get their team an extra possession, got to respect that.
Oh, no doubt about it.
Durg on the wing. Pass to Durg.
Durg,
good
again,
move.
Passing up an open three.
Manios at the wing.
Looks like Fitch will definitely be giving up a lot of threes, or three opportunities tonight.
Yeah, they're not playing very tight tonight.
No, they're playing a pretty laid-back zone.
Trying to stop the ISO. Durg with another three.
Off the mark.
He's now one for three.
Lorenzo Russo pushing
and
up the floor.
Out of bounds.
That's a kick ball.
Fitch's possession.
Oh, four Tigers look like they kicked that one.
Fitch
Lorenzo
inbound
Russo
it.
Inbound it now. He gets it into Simons. He'll go to work on Barrett. He'll kick it out. And bang. Shot is good. Nice hit there from Tommy Liskovic.
He now has four.
6-3. Falcons.
Durg on the wing. Howland's had a little bit of a tough time getting the ball inside. Already shooting four threes.
This 2-3 zone is definitely giving him a lot of problems right now.
Pass to Sperling.
Can't seem to get Nathan Barrett's closed up, but they got it to him now.
And the moment he got it, he was double teamed. Frankie Buckets with the shot. And that looks like it's out of bounds off the pitch. Yep, it's going to be Howland's ball still.
That's just the Nathan Barrett presence right there. He's not always grabbing the rebounds, but forcing tips and stuff like that.
Yeah, he's a very tough and physical guy. I played football with him. You know, he was a big hitter, and he's very strong. It's going to be hard to move him out of the way.
He doesn't really seem all that big, especially compared to Liskovic, but he can move anyone down there in the paint.
And speaking of rebounding, he played wide receiver and made second team all county. So he can catch.
Jones the two, up and it
and
falls.
Good shot by Jones. First points of the night for him. Fitch will take it back up.
Simons now with it on the wing. Nathan Barrett on him.
Drives
he'll
the side.
Drive.
Oh, and that looks like
a little too much too much grease on the floor as he slides.
Shuffle the feet.
Tigers might look to push it here. Fitch seems a little lackadaisical.
Yep. Durg on the wing. Almost dies to shoot another three. Frankie Manios on the wing. Jones will take another shot. And bang. 4 points for Jones in the first quarter now.
2 for 2. Nice little mid-range shots.
Fitch takes it back up. Sperling guarding.
Simon's now open. Driving into the paint.
He's driving.
He'll spin.
Little hook shot and in. Great shot by Scheinman. That's hard to contest.
Yeah, nothing you can really do about that one. 8-7 Falcons now as Sperling pushes us up the floor. He'll find Barrett in the corner. He'll look to try to get it down low to Jones.
Crossover. Good move. Oh, got Dirk wide open inside. Nice shot by Dirk. Great pass.
Great cut, great pass. Great team basketball right there. Simons
will take another shot.
Ooh, fading away. No. Looked like it went off the glass, too. Great shot there for Simons.
Simons is making his presence known in this first quarter.
Both teams going back and forth right here. Shot for shot. Manios now to get the offense going.
Could be a high scoring, high entertaining game here at this pace. Dirk on the wing. Back to Sperling.
He's looking to find someone.
Has Manios on the wing.
Bear with it.
Bear looking for something to do. Gives it back to Manios.
Dirk open on the wing. He'll shoot that three.
And
it's good.
Dirk's second three of the quarter.
That's 8 points for Cameron Dirk. Great start for him tonight. Taylor again taking it up the floor.
Dirk is on fire in these past games, and he looks like we're going to witness another great game tonight.
Contested jumper. No good. Rebound, though, for the Falcons.
Howland's going to have to stop offensive rebounds, and this past games are having a problem with that.
Especially against Canfield. They gave up too many second-chance points. Couldn't stop that.
Team should get one chance to score if they want a chance to win.
Nice pass down low to Liskovic.
Is that a foul?
That calls on Frankie Manios. Tommy Liskovic will go to the line now to shoot two free throws.
Liskovic is a big man to stop inside.
All 6'5 of them.
Take two shots.
First one's no good. And also, correction on that. Let's go back. Height stat. 6'2".
We'll take a second shot here. It's up and good.
Not too common to see someone jumping there on their free throw.
12-11, Howland.
Looked like
Tomko has checked in at point guard for the Tigers.
Fitch is going to put a little press on. But.
And six-man Vitaly, have we talked about before, scoring 11 points last game, isn't for the Tigers, hoping to make his presence known.
Barrett now driving into the paint. He finds an open Manios. He won't shoot, but he'll find Dirk.
Back to Dirk. Manios.
Try to get the ball to the hot hand.
Back to Tomko. Tomko, not the biggest guy, but plays with a lot of heart.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it.
He's a very good passer, very smart with the ball. And that looks like there's two guys took a charge at the same time there. You don't see that very often.
That was a great bailout, though, for the Tigers. Nathan Barrett was called for a travel. What would have looked to have been a charge anyways.
Would have been a second in the quarter,
I think. Yeah, he would have had to sit down maybe for the whole half. Could not have let that happen.
Yeah, it's not good.
Checking in the game for the Falcons is number 3, Stevie Woodbury, and also number 5, Nate Liskovic.
Fitch will take it back up. Gotta watch dribbling that loose there on Tomko. He's a pickpocket. Averages tons of steals.
Simons now with it. See what he can do on offense.
Pass to the corner. And inside.
Liskovic to Liskovic.
And a little bit of air on that shot.
Manios now will take it up the floor.
Tomko has it. Vitaly contested. Back to Vitaly.
He gets it down low to Barrett. Kicking it out to Manios.
Manios
three is up.
Three.
Bam. And it's good.
Frankie Buckus with another three.
Steal by Tomko. He's fouled. Shot won't count, but great awareness from Tomko to pressure up the floor and get the quick steal.
As you mentioned before, Drew, Fitch is playing very loose as Howland has made tons of threes in this first quarter because of it. They're going to have to start playing tighter if they want a chance to stop these threes.
That type of turnover can't happen for Fitch. And quickly, Woodbury will check out after that turnover. Tomko to inbound to here. Four across the free throw line. They get it into Barrett.
Barrett will do with a quick in and out, pass to Vitaly, and
Vitaly will be shooting free throws now. He's shooting about 70% on the year. Second on the team. Actually, third on the team. But Manny, since he hasn't shot enough free throws, his free throw percentage doesn't count towards the county leaders, like Vitaly's.
I see. Vitaly's very good at drawing fouls. Him and Barrett shoot that post hook on the inside and get either an and one or two free throws out of it.
They're great at getting using their body to generate shots.
Sperling will check back in for the Tigers as we see Durig and Barrett leave.
Justin Jones also checking into the game. Second free throw now from Vitaly.
Up and good. Off the rim and in. Got the friendly roll. Fitch will take it back up. Pass back out to Simons. Back.
Taylor with it now, trying to get the offense going. Tigers switching to a little zone defense. Oh, that's going to be a second foul on Frankie Manios. He'll probably have to come out of this game.
He'll be sitting soon. It's a tough blow. He already has two threes this quarter. Pitch to inbound. And to Simons will put it up. And another shot for Simons.
Nice look then. Got to have better defense there on that inbounds play. Can't get the little easy inbound pass to Simons. He'll make that shot every time.
No, sure. He's the most talented scorer on Fitch's team. He'll shoot that every time.
Swinging around to Tomko. No one looking to take a shot.
Spurling up. And off the back of the rim. Howard has a particularly small lineup having Sperling and Tomko in at the same time.
Just 7 seconds now. Simons with it.
And Simons will probably take the last shot. Oh, no, he'll pass it out. And
three's
for
up.
Three.
No good. And after the first quarter, we have your Howland Tigers leading 17-13. We'll be right back after this short commercial break.
We take pride in being called Howland Tigers.
We are proud of our tradition and strive to maintain that excellence.
We are Howland, and to us, that means a proud past and a roaring future.
We have a motto at Howland Schools that we stand by, and it's character counts, no excuses.
We are a team, faculty, students, parents, and community.
We are all one.
And that's what being a Tiger is all about.
We are Howland. We are all one.
All right, and we're back. Howland leads Fitch Falcons 17-13. It's been a pretty great start for the Tigers. They came out a lot more aggressive than their first time around against Fitch. I mean, really recently, this is just a completely different Howland team. If you watched any games at the start of the season to games now, it's like two different teams.
Brand new team.
I don't know what happened at the Harden game, but since then, they have been tremendous. One of the best teams in the area.
Sometimes all a team needs is that one big win to get their momentum and their confidence high, and it's uphill from there. What I've noticed in this game is Fitch's loose D at the three-point line, and it's hurting them. Durick has two threes. Emanios has two threes. Howland is making their threes, and Fitch is going to have to start playing tighter, which it looks like they are.
Going a little man-to-man now. First time tonight.
Vitaly inside. That's Tomko at the top of the key. Back to Sperling.
Sperling now getting double-teamed. He gets it over to Tomko. Yeah.
Defense is a lot tighter now. The coach must have made some adjustments after the quarter.
Tomko, though,
for three. Boom! Another three for Howland.
Great ball movement there. Fitch was running a lot of double teams at Howland, and they got the open
Simons
shooter.
Simons shoots three, and that's his. Oh, that might. Was that Simons? Yes, sir. Yes, it was.
That was Lorenzo Russo.
Oh, my bad.
Tomko, another three. That's two in a row for Tomko. Big three there, and he is very excited. Timeout, Fitch.
Tomko is hype. Little guy has the most heart I've ever seen on the basketball court. He is not scared of anybody.
Oh, what a swing here for the Tigers. Right out of the half. Right after the quarter. You brought it right to Fitch. Extending the lead to double digits. See if they can keep it here now.
They're just going to have to defend that three. Howland is absolutely scorching from the three-point line.
They are on fire.
And I'm going to guess during this timeout, the coach is going to say, I don't want to see any more open threes, because that's what I'd be saying right now.
Oh, no doubt. If you're Fitch, you can't be running these double teams. And no. Howland's been running a lot of screens. Switch the screens, cover the shooters. Big men haven't done much to you right now, so.
You know, simple math. You got two guys on one guy, one's going to be open, and Howland's capitalizing every time.
Oh, definitely. Reuben Taylor now taking up the floor for the Falcons. Number 33, Tyler Jarris in the game for the Falcons for the first time.
Pump fake, shot is up, and off.
Tomko boxed out there, but two big guys just went right over.
Pass back out to top of the key.
Top. Right now. Looking to go on Sperling.
We'll drive inside.
We'll find Jaros.
And tough shot.
Fouled by Jones. That's only his first of the night, though.
It's a good foul. You know, I'd rather see a foul than an easy layup.
Let's see how Jaros can shoot the free throw.
Howland has gained momentum fast. Those two threes from Tomko have changed the whole complexion of this game.
See if Tigers can keep it going now.
First shot is up and off the rim and out.
Looks like number zero, DeAndre McKeever, is about to check in the first time tonight for the Falcons.
Second shot's up and good. 23-14 Howland we have right now.
McKeever is in for Chris Brown. A little full court pressure now for the Falcons. Sperling will have to deal with that.
They're now starting to press. Passes to Barrett, will take it up. And to Jones. Tomko, another three. Will you have to go three in a row?
Oh. Nice rebound by Barrett, though, and he'll go up again. Misses.
But yeah, gets another rebound. Now. And
that one's on the floor. Looks like he got fouled in the first one, but no call.
Barrett's not very happy with that.
He knows he's got to make that one. Anytime he gets it on the block, he's disappointed if he misses it.
Yeah, because most of the time he will capitalize. Sprinting the inbound.
Jaros checking out, and Liskovec back in the game.
Back to Barrett, shots up, and out. Sperling, nice rebound by Sperling. Good
right
hustle.
It's a rebound. Tomko now driving, finds Derrick. I'll swing it over to Sperling.
Back to Tomko, I'm sorry.
Tomko getting pressure out front. Gotta avoid the 5 second call.
Howland's trying to set up a play. Fitch's defense is much tighter now.
McKeever almost got the steal there. Howland tends to struggle more with pressure, so be interesting to see if Fitch stays with it or will go back to that more laid-back zone.
It looks like that tight defense is working. And that was
an air pass there from the Tigers, and Fitch will look to push. Simons now.
Inside, and good fight for the ball by Jones. Gets the steal.
Tigers will quickly push.
Fast break opportunity with the spring with the layup, and he misses that one.
Simons now driving quickly. Look at Russo. He'll swing it out of the tally. Simons now driving
inside
to the paint.
And we'll take a layup.
And one. Nice move there. A little floater.
I think that would be Simons' 10th point of the night. Maybe 11th if he gets this free throw.
And what might be even more important than that is that that's Nathan Barrett's second foul.
That's not good.
Looks like something also happened to Justin Jones, maybe a bloody nose. He'll have to check out of the game.
Bloody nose?
Getting checked by the trainer now. Can't be on the floor with any blood on you.
Must have just suffered some sort of nose injury prior, because he is currently wearing a mask.
Hard to see that happen.
Simon's shot is up.
No good. Rebounded by
Sperling.
No
and one for him. Simon's has 10 points. Sperling will take it up.
23-16 Tigers.
Barrett sets a screen for Sperling. Tried to run a pick and roll there.
Shuffled his feet a little bit too much. And he'll be coming out of the game for Frankie Manius.
Sperling have a bit of a struggle, but I feel like, you know, once he gets the flow of the game, he'll fix it.
Number 5, Nate Liskovec, now in the game again for the Falcons.
Tomko guarding the top of the key, and layup is out. Good defense by Tomko.
Nice rebound by Joey Vitale. Looking to find a guard to get up the floor.
Derg now has it.
A little bit of hand checking there. Good timeout there from Bubon.
Yeah.
With the 10-second call.
That was a needed timeout. Howland cannot seem to get the ball past half court.
Tigers have to go get it down low. Try to get an easy bucket here on this possession. They've been swinging around too much on the top of the key. Get it down low. Get it to big man. Let them go to work.
Yes, because these things are no longer working with Fitch's new man-to-man zone, or man-to-man concept. Try to get Barrett, Vitale, or Jones on the inside.
They've been most of your offense all year. Get it down low. Let big man go to work.
It's worked all year. It's worked all year. Don't stop now.
Go feed him.
You know, we got three very talented big men. And we're coming back.
All on the floor for the Tigers, Frankie Manios, Joey Vitale, Gage Tomko, and Cameron Dury. Fitch will stay in this bit of a, more of a half-court press as they won't go all the way back to get Tomko.
Tomko will try and take it up. Passes half-court. Nice crossover.
He gets a switch.
Oh, great pass to Barrett.
Oh, Barrett hit. No call. Not sure about how they missed that one.
Looked like a foul to me, but that pass by Tomko was an excellent setup. It was, threw a bullet in there.
Now that one off the hands of Vitaly, and it'll still be Falcons' ball. All right.
Isn't the first time the refs seem to miss a foul call? As you said, they're letting them play.
Oh, yeah, they are. It's better than a touchy game, at least.
Yeah. I got to agree with you on that one. Fitch will inbound. Pass out.
Ruben Taylor now with the ball. He'll try to go to work on Tomko.
Showing some crafty moves. Not seeming to work, though. Tomko's staying on him. Locked down deep.
Great defense there. They have to kick it out to Simons. Simons now will go one-on-one with Barrett.
Driving inside. Shot is up.
Nice shot there, Tanya Liskovic.
There's been multiple times that Liskovic has taken that same shot, that mid-range on the corner.
It's a good look for him.
Seems to like it a lot. Oh, and it's a turnover for Howland.
Tigers and a foul on Gage Tomko. A little bit of shoving after the play.
Oh, got some physical play here.
Both teams very emotional.
Yes. I love the heart and the passion, but we got to make sure we don't get any stupid technicals to help take us out of the game later.
Number two, Chris Brown checking into the game for the Falcons.
Pass to the corner.
Brown with it now, and he'll get it back to Tolley. Taylor, sorry.
Top of the key. Oh, good move.
Nice move on Tomko.
And it still doesn't work. Tomko's able to stay with him.
Tally with the rebound, and he gets it to Tomko, and he'll look to push it quickly.
Pass to Frankie. Manios. Back to Barrett. We got Vitaly on the post. Are they going to give it to him? Yes, they will.
Nice.
High low.
Little 1-2 action there for the Tiger big men. Great cut from Nathan Barrett.
The high low play works a lot for the Tigers.
Nathan Barrett, no points. Opportunity to finally score here tonight. Don't see that too often.
Very surprising. Tigers' highest scores. Very surprising to see him scoreless here. First free throw is up and good. First point of the night for Barrett.
He is shooting almost 80% now from the line on the year.
Very efficient. Can you get ready for the next free throw? Can you go 2 for 2? Nope.
Off the mark. Rebound by Simons.
He's pushing fast. Fast break opportunity. And is that a charge?
Oh, that's not a great play there for Barrett. He can't get in front of him.
I think that is his third foul.
That is his third foul. Got to make sure your feet are set on that charge attempt.
Yeah, it's going to take a charge, but if you have two fouls already, you might just have to let him get the bucket.
Yeah, when you're running side by side with someone, fast break, got to let the guy go.
Hopefully that doesn't affect Barrett in the future. In this fourth quarter, if it's tight, we're going to need him.
Jones Wild now have to come into the game for Barrett. Also checking in, number 33, Tyler Jarris.
Hoping that bloody nose for Jones is all healed up now. Second free throw is up. And good. Tomko will take it up. Try to take it up fast to get past this press. Nice spin move.
He finds Vitaly. Vitaly will drive into the paint. He'll swing around the top. Tomko again for three. No good.
Almost got his third three of the game.
Simons now quickly pushing. Oh, what a move.
That was a nice finger roll. Oh, but wait. That might have been.
Paul's going to be on the floor there as that's Jones' second foul.
Our big men are fouling bad here. Simons has proven to be a problem for us right now. Only a sophomore. He's tough to handle.
Really got to run out on him.
Sperling will check in.
He's been running the floor very well right now. Correction, they gave the and one call there.
I'm a little surprised on that one.
24-20, I guess. Would have assumed that was on the floor. But I guess.
And he converts the and. Oh, is he getting another free throw
now? But. Grabbing a little scoring
malfunction right now.
Yeah, I'm a little confused on this one. He's getting two free throws, so they must not have gave him the N1. And he makes both free throws.
24-22, Tigers. Their lead is only down to just two now. Jones' pass almost stolen away.
It's a very high-energy game. The Tigers lead from 10 to just 2. And that's a turnover by Howland. Oh, no, and they will get it right back.
Tomko
takes it. Sperling has it. He's got Durig open on the wing. He won't shoot it.
Their guards now. Sorry, the Howland guards are swinging around the top of the key.
Durig
open three.
For three.
No good.
Front of the rim.
Simon's now quickly pushing. Again, trying to generate some offense.
These three-point shots are proving a lot less effective in the second quarter for the Tigers.
Manius will get a shot now, trying to stop him. He's got two fouls. He can't pick one up.
And
he'll leave open the mid-range, and it's no good.
Turnover
by Simons. Oh, great
block! Get that out of
Justin
here.
Jones
says, get save. That out of here. You can't come weak like that against Justin Jones. He'll smack it out. Though, Fitch still does get points.
Game all knotted up now, 24. Tigers need a bucket. They've been scoreless for a long stretch here.
Very double team Sperling. We got Manios open.
Manios.
The
third
three. Bang! Frankie Buckets with his third three of the game.
He quiets the Fitch crowd. 27-24 Tigers. Fitch now looking to answer. Chris Brown with it, looking to drive.
Oh, pick and roll going. Are they going to use it? Nope. Drive inside. And
he's hit by Jones.
It's another foul by a big man.
Is that Jones' second or third now?
I'm not sure. But, you know, with Barrett having three, Vitaly having two, and Jones having at least two, these big men are really getting close here.
Vitaly's going to have to check back into the game now for Jones, probably.
Front of the rim and out.
Lorenzo Russo missed the front end of his two free throws. Second one coming.
It's up. And 0 for 2 on them.
But they grabbed the offensive rebound. Got a box out there.
No offensive. We can't. And for three.
Okay.
That's out. Good hustle play by Sperling.
Oh, that foul is on Sperling as well.
I'm a little surprised to see that.
No, action calls my apologies. That one's on Lorenzo Russo. He'll have to check out of the game with his second foul.
About a minute and a half left before halftime.
Stevie Woodbury checks in the game. 1-1 now for Jordan Sperling.
Sperling scores right now, looking to get his first points. First one is up.
No good. Tompkins get the ball right back.
Drives inside. And is
Woodbury
that a charge?
Drives.
Good charge.
Charge.
Put his body
right
on the line
for Tomko.
Tomko says, I'll take a little bit of pain if we get the ball for it.
Falcons bluff the full court pressure. Now they actually do come with it.
Sperling taking it up fast. Double teams him. Pass to Durig. Nice move.
I'll swing around the top of the key. They find Durig.
It looks as Fitch is doubling anyone who gets the ball right now.
Tom Cotamanius. Another
Frankie Buckets,
up.
Another shot.
Oh, almost spins in. No call there down low. Vitaly hit hard.
And drive inside. Layup is up. And
nice
in.
Move for Chris Brown.
1 point game. Under a minute here before halftime.
Tigers have to answer. Sperling.
And
almost goes out of bounds, but he turns it over anyways. Brown driving. Up and under, and
another layup. Fitch is now taking the lead.
Put a little English on that one.
Howland has lost a 10-point lead in the second quarter. They're going to have to find an adjustment.
It's been a tremendous 12-4
run. Tomko open for, and won't make that one. And it looks like Fitch may hold it for the last shot, and we'll have their best scorer take it up.
Manius will have to try to stop him here. He can't pick up a third foul either. 10 seconds on the clock.
Simon's
dribbling
out
to the last second. He'll go to work. 1-on-1. Spinning. Open
oh,
left.
What a move.
And it's good. Great shot
what
there
a move
Simons.
By Simons. What a move. 16 points in only the first half for Simons. We're going to have to stop him. Coach is going to have to make some adjustments to get him out of the game.
Not a good way to close the half to the Tigers. 30-27. Before we go into halftime, though, let's take a quick look at the Tigers' upcoming schedule. On Tuesday, January 29th, they have the Boardman Spartans. On Friday, February 1st, they have the Harding Raiders. On Tuesday, February 5th, they travel to Lakeside to face the Dragons. And on Friday, February 8th, they get another rematch at Camp Field.
I'm excited for the Harding game. Based off that last game, we're going to have another great one.
Well, at the half, Tigers trail 30-27 to Fitch. We'll be right back after this half.
Here at Howland Local Schools, public education means every kid, every day. We take pride in knowing that our students are receiving every opportunity they need to succeed in whatever path they take.
Our certified staff provides engaging instruction in all academic areas.
We communicate with our students and our families to make sure we are all working as one.
Collaborate with community partners to help promote professionalism.
We are committed to make the necessary changes to make education beneficial for each and every student.
Our athletics and activities give students the opportunity to reach a common goal.
Our teachers use creative methods to indulge us in learning and teach us how to express ourselves as individuals.
We provide our students with methods to think outside the box to meet their objectives.
With public education, we are all one. Our success is measured by every student, every day.
Here's to the crazy ones, the rebels, troublemakers, the ones who see things differently. While some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.
These hallways are built on pride and tradition. As a public school district, we will always promote, protect, and fight for what's best, because that's what Roaring Tigers do for our kids and community. We embrace the pride of our past and continue to strategically create and foster the future for our kids and families through innovative practices. We have an open and sustained vision that focuses on innovation as the benchmark for our students. Nothing beats public education, and there is no better place to be educated than Howland Local Schools.
Overdose deaths are skyrocketing across the country and right here in the valley.
Addiction doesn't discriminate. It can happen to anyone. Drugs don't single out certain groups, show bias towards anyone, or judge who you are. Drugs aren't impartial and certainly don't individualize. It doesn't matter who you are, what race you are, or how financially sound you are. If you're homeless, if you have a family who loves you dearly. Addiction destroys the person who's using and destroys the families involved. Addiction robs you of your money, it robs you of your spirit, and finally, when you have nothing left to lose, robs you of your soul. Why let it play with lives? Just stop. It does not discriminate. It kills, it cheats, it steals, it takes over, it ruins lives, it shames, it lies, and it disappoints. Discriminate? Not when it comes to addiction.
It is an honor to attend Howland Schools, and that couldn't have been more evident than at our All One Showcase. Our faculty and staff, retired teachers, community partners, families, and friends came together to celebrate our schools. In turn, they all created a night to remember. We want to thank everyone who attended and supported our event, which highlighted everything that makes Howland Local Schools a premier school district in Trumbull County. From education to the arts, memories of how proud our past is, and a look at our roaring future, the showcase had it all, and the turnout at our inaugural event demonstrates our commitment to unity. Again, thank you, and as always, our proud past and roaring future is only possible with your support and all you do for kids and community.
And we're back. First, we're going to look at the leading scores for each team. Cameron Durig has 8 points for the Tigers, and Todd Simons is leading all scores with 16 for the Falcons. Simons' post moves have been amazing right now.
Simons has been very hard to guard today.
All right, let's look back through the keys of the game. For the Tigers, play through Berry. They have not done that at all.
Only 1 point, I think, right?
Only 1 point, and he hasn't gotten many post touches. He also picked up three fouls, which... it's going to leave him out of the game for even longer. Protect the basketball. Through the first quarter and the start of the second, they did a great job at that. But since then, they've had a lot of turnovers since Fitch upped the pressure. And they, at first, it did look like they were keeping the momentum.
It was a 10-point lead.
But they lost all their momentum, and Fitch came out the much better team. And for the Fitch, execute your offense. Well, they haven't really ran much offense, but getting the ball to Todd Simon has done the trick.
It's really working.
Take away the bigs. They have done an amazing job at that. They've been fronting every post, and none of them have really been able to get going. Justin Jones has had a couple mid-range shots, but really nothing down low. Vitaly, Barrett, Jones, all three have been pretty quiet for the most part. And hard-nosed defense. They didn't do that at first. They were playing a pretty lackadaisical zone. Wasn't working for them. They switched this high-pressure man, and it's been awesome for them.
Yes, that zone they were running, giving up a lot of open threes, and Howland was making them. Tomko hit the 2 threes in a row to give Howland the 10-point lead, and directly after that, they fixed it, and it's working because they have now gained a 3-point lead after the end of the half.
Be interesting to see what type of halftime adjustments the Tigers make.
What they're going to have to do is they're going to have to start using the pick and roll effectively, but at least trying to get Barrett and Jones shots on the inside.
The only problem is you're going to have to leave Barrett out of the game for a while.
With those fouls, correct. You're right on that one.
Can't really risk putting him in until around halfway through the third quarter. Anything else is very, very risky. You know you need him on the floor. He's the main catalyst of your offense, but that's a tough, tough decision here for Bubon.
Yeah, you know, either you let him play and, you know, hope he's careful enough to not get that fourth foul, or you play it safe.
Then again, he does nothing for you on your bench either, so might as well have him out there.
Vitaly and Jones can also run that pick and roll effectively, but I think both of them have at least two fouls as well. I think Jones, does he have three?
Jones, they had him listed on the board with two, but I thought he had three myself.
Well, that just shows how tough Fitch is playing, you know?
Mm-hmm. All right, just about 50 seconds here before we get underway.
I think we're in store for a great game. Close one at the half, and I think we're going to see a tough finish.
Yeah, definitely. Tigers have to come out, answer this Falcon pressure, and bring it to them.
Howland has shot well from the three, but they're not getting any more open shots. If they do, they're making them. Durg, I think, has two. Manios, I think,
has two.
Two as well. Maybe three. Was it three?
Two. He's got 6 points on the night.
Oh, I'm sorry. I must have counted wrong. But be interesting to see how the Tigers rebound now.
And 10 seconds till second half begins.
So the Falcons, they didn't really use a whole lot of substitutions, but it'd be interesting to see if they keep their same lineup out there with this full court pressure.
I did not see Simons leave the floor very often. With 16 points,
on to take him off.
He doesn't seem to be fatigued. He must be used to playing these kind of minutes.
And surprisingly for the Tigers, Nathan Barrett finds himself out on the floor already.
You better be careful.
He won't be guarding Simons right away, though. Try to not pick up a quick foul.
And Fitch will get the ball first to start this second half. Tough defense by Howland.
Simons comes away, though.
I'm glad to hear the student section finally cheering right now.
Finally standing up, getting into it.
Yes.
Tolley now. See what he can do.
Pass out. Pass it on the corner. Pass to Simons.
A little two-man action down low for the Falcons.
And shot by Simons. And a rare miss from him. But Howland gives up an offensive rebound. He cannot do that.
That's double dribble there. A little too much thinking there. Not enough action.
That'll do it.
Barrett now inbound. Gotta be careful not to pick up a charge here.
I saw you shoot that half-court shot, Drew. It didn't seem to go in. What happened there?
All right.
The wind.
You pushed it a little to the right. If you look, the door is open on the left. It must have given me a little too much of a breeze there. Had the right strength.
I see.
Nice shot there from Justin Jones, 30-29, Falcons.
Not one to talk. I'm not the best basketball player either. I love to talk about it, though.
Same here. Tyler again setting up the offense.
Durga's guarding Simons tightly. Simons will pass it out.
They'll get it over to Brown. Brown finds Russo.
4-3.
His shot's no good.
Rebound by Jones.
Dirk pushing up the floor.
And shots up by Dirk, and that's a good shot. That is his 10th point of the night.
And it'll give the Tigers the 31-30 lead. Big shot. Tolley again trying to set up the offense.
Not much going on for Fitch right now.
Oh, it's a double screen for Simons, and he finds it.
Simons will most likely put that one up. He has a great post move. And he does. He doesn't get that one, but he gets his own rebound and misses it again.
Nice rebound from Barrett. Manny has now to push up the floor. And they're able to find Sperling.
And he's trying to set something up.
A screen from Jones. Or no, it's just a little pass.
Here on the inside. Puts up his hook shot. And it's not working tonight for him.
Simon's now quickly pushing.
Simons drives. Good pass.
Finds Russo.
And that's a foul.
Travel.
That's a travel.
I was gonna say that would have been a very unfortunate fourth foul for Barrett. And
he would have lost
straight up. Traveling's the call though.
And Fitch is pressing again.
Looks like the double's gonna come.
Barrett will drive it inside. We gotta watch drive it. Manios for three.
No. Rebound by Dirk. He's fouled on the tip in. He'll get two shots. Nice smart play there.
Dirk is a very reliable free throw shooter. Wouldn't be surprised to see both of these go in.
Derek, only a junior, get to see him again next year.
He's having a monster season, multiple 20-point performances for him this year.
Really been a great spark plug for the Tigers.
First one is in.
Filling the roles of the many lost seniors from last year.
Yeah, you know, people were very surprised to see how these young people of Howland, you know, freshmen, sophomores, and juniors have come. And really, really, you can't really tell that it's some of their first year on varsity. They're really catching it very fast.
It's, for the most, other than Nathan Barrett, it's
very new
all their first year.
It's a very little.
Manny has had some minutes, not like he's had this year, though.
We're going to see even, you know, more sophomores in varsity next year, like, you know, the Masucci's.
Yeah.
And good hustle play, and that's going to be Tiger's ball. Nope, wait, Fitch's ball. Sorry.
No, that's Tiger ball.
Oh, my bad.
Sperling again. I'm going to deal with the pressure all night long.
Good crossover move. Sperling very crafty with the ball.
Got to get it across. Almost a 10-second violation.
Driving inside. Manios for Ohm. Thought he should shoot another three. Got tripped up there. And that looked Looks like a foul to me. I don't know.
Shot blocked by Simons, I guess. Tigers will keep possession.
These refs are, you know, playing some street ball here. We're not going to call a foul unless he has to. Some physical
nice
play.
From Manios.
He's fouled and one.
And great one. Move from Frankie Manios.
He is excited, as he should be. What a play. Good and one by Manios.
He saw he didn't have anyone on him. Quickly cut to the block and laid it in. And now he's got a shot.
Nice show of the muscle.
Oh, a little muscle from Manios. Checking in the game for the Falcons is DeAndre McKeever.
Ricky Buckets.
That's 8 points tonight for him.
There's a chance for 9. It's up. And one is complete. Howland has a 6-point lead.
He's shooting almost 90% from the free throw line this year.
That is excellent. Amazing. That is excellent.
He's got to have a couple more to get on the county leaderboards, though.
Yes, sir.
McKeever now.
No, but Simons. With most of Manios' shots coming from the outside, so he doesn't get fouled very often.
No.
Durg will take it up fast. Oh, good move.
Finding Manios. He'll fade away.
Another shot.
Shot no good. Rebound by Simons.
Barrett
gets
away
by Barrett and knocked off his own foot. Falcons now running quickly. Simons.
And that was a 3-on-1. There's not much throwing could do there.
Just had a jab at someone.
And that is 18 for Simons.
36-32 Tigers. Sparling quickly driving up the floor. He finds Durg. Jones posting up. He gets it down low.
And
his pass to Barrett. Tipped away. He
puts
keeps
it.
And he's fouled. He's got 2 shots now coming.
Jones, a reliable free throw shooter.
Jones now, first free throw coming.
First one is up and in.
Sperling checking out for Gage Tomko.
I'm always impressed to watch Tomko play, being we're the same height, but yet I could not survive on the varsity basketball court. Blocks all day. Justin makes both.
And now he'll come out of the game for Joey Vitale. Also for the Falcons, number 33, Tyler Jarris checks in the game.
Fitch will take it up. Drive it inside.
Simons will pull up.
And almost got his 20 piece, but not that one.
Ethan Barrett now to take it out for the Tigers.
Pass to Tomko. Tomko will take it up fast.
Quickly beating it. But he steps out, and that will be a Falcon ball.
It's an unfortunate turnover for Howland. We can't have those.
Looks like Tomko will match the pressure with a little pressure of his own, too.
Fitch will take it. Tomko, very tough to get past. He's a very, very good defender. Locked out.
It's Kovac setting up the offense. He finds McKeever. McKeever
drives inside for the layup. And
that's a foul on Barrett. He didn't. That's a tough one. I stayed with him. That's his fourth, though.
I'm not one to call flop, but flop.
He just fell. Barrett kind of just stood there. That's a tough one right there.
Not much contact on that one.
Looks like
but
Jordan's,
you know what? Guess it's a smart play, whatever gets you free throws.
Looks like Sperling will be coming into the game for him.
And as we talked about, Barrett now picks up his fourth foul. He need to be very careful. He has to come out now.
That's what I was saying earlier about putting him in too early. Now they have got to deal with Albert at least midway through the fourth quarter, probably. Don't leave him on the bench too long, though. Can't give away any possessions. Keever now, second free throw. It's cut it to 4.
Up and good. 4-point lead now for the Tigers.
Woodbury checks in the game for the Falcons.
Retired inbound to Sperling.
Sperling, 1-on-1, trying to get past Skovac.
So he's got Vitale on the wing and pass to Tomko. Tomko will take it inside. Great setup, Durg. Almost
shot.
Almost another 3 for Durg.
Simons now. He'll push it in himself.
Up and under. That is 20 for Simons. Only the third quarter.
38-36 Tigers. Their lead is dwindled back down to two. Vitaly driving on Woodbury.
We got to find a way to stop. Simons is taking that shot. The step back fadeaway has worked for him every time.
Manny has three, no good. Rebound by McKeever. Now Simons again quickly pushing. And
I wouldn't be surprised to see him shoot another one as a heat check.
One-on-one on Dirk.
And it looks like, oh, very unselfish play. Nice pass.
Get down one of Dirk. He'll get it to go. Tie ball game here. Timeout Fitch. Full timeout. With your score of 38-38, we'll be right back after this short commercial break.
Here at Howland Local Schools, public education.
It's time we have that conversation. You may not understand me, but one day you will.
Hey, buddy. We need to talk about choices.
Okay, Dad.
You may find yourself in a situation where you have to make a decision. The question is which choice will you make?
How could you do this to yourself? You ruined your life. If only you remembered that one conversation, things would be different.
All right, with this game all knotted up at 38 apiece, 2:38 left in the third quarter, we've got ourselves a great ball game. Fitch coming out of their timeout looking to put a little full-court pressure probably on the Tigers.
Very close ball game. It seems every time Howland seems to put on a run as they come out to a six-point lead, Fitch bounces right back and either ties it up or takes the lead again.
Big key here for the Tigers. This is a big stretch without Nathan Barrett. They've got to find some offense. And, of course, some defensive rebounding as well as he does
and Todd
just
Simons,
about everything.
Todd Simons is absolutely scorching the Tigers' defense. 20 points in only the third quarter. Oh, almost a steal.
Looks like a zone press coming for the Falcons. So Burling's going to have to move quickly to beat this.
Oh, and pass to Durg on the wing.
He's got
We got a little bit of foul play down there. Vitaly with the fall. Another fall and another one. We got dominoes on the court.
Foul finally called on Woodbury. That's his second of the night. Spurling to inbound here for the Tigers.
And oh,
nice
play there. Almost a steal.
Hold on to that one.
Good catch. And another.
And like a slot receiver making that play.
So a little bit of ankles taken away right there. Manios, pass to Spurling. Tomko.
Tomko.
To Durant. I was going to make something happen here. Just passing the ball around.
He finds Spurling. Spurling to go to work. Trying to shoot the floater, but he's fouled as he's hit on the arm. Fitch fans not happy about that call.
They don't like that.
Thought they saw a lot of ball there.
You know it, but nope. As they say, refs never gonna change their call. See guys in the NBA like LeBron and Harden love to argue with the ref, but never ever seen a ref go, oh, you're right, let me change that. Never seen it before.
Tomko, another three up, no good. Rebound by the Falcons. It's the most I've ever seen Tomko shoot in a game this year. Much more aggressive than usual.
I think he's made two. Simons, I'm very surprised to see him pass with that three.
He'll drive on Spurling.
And
he can't
pass.
Find him in
just will keep possession.
Corral it. It'll be Falcons ball here. Jones checking in the game. Add a little more size as Tomko comes out. He'll go on Jaros. Jaros with it.
Simons
getting down to Simons. His shot just off the mark.
It's a rare miss from him tonight.
But he'll get his own offensive
nice
rebound.
Nice hustle play.
It's going to be a foul on the floor first as Spurling gave him a little push.
Fitch to inbound it. They got still a tie game here with about a minute and a half left in the third quarter. Very close and contested game. Simons has the ball again. We'll drive it inside. And
left hand
another
no
missed
good.
Layup for him.
Jaros up. Again, no good.
Good rebound by Spurling.
It's like four or five missed layups in a row for the Falcons.
It's very
big
surprising.
Break for the Tigers.
They've been very efficient and down low today. Manios pump fakes. It doesn't take the three.
And Spurling quickly ripped.
Another And fast break, Liverpool.
Nice move there.
Fish will take a 2-point lead, 40-38.
Nate Liskovic, great move. Derg with it now.
Under a minute here. Vitaly to Sperling. Back to Derg.
For three. Up for Sperling.
And off the rim and out.
Quickly rebound by Woodbury. He'll push it up the floor. Simons with it.
Simons may hold up for the last shot, as he did at the end of the second quarter.
Looks like the Falcons will wait to end this quarter.
I wouldn't be surprised to get in, you know, number 23's hands, as he has not missed very often.
No, but they'll look to waste a little time first.
And there it is. He'll be guarded by Derg. Can he stop him?
Well, pull-up shot. No good. Gets the rebound. Shot again. Blocked by Derg this time. Right off Sperling's head.
And
that's the end of the quarter.
The end of the quarter, we have Fitch leading 40-38. Very tight game here. Can Howland come back and take this W?
We'll be right back after this short commercial break.
These hallways are built on pride and tradition. As a public school district, we will always promote, protect, and fight for what's best, because that's what Roaring Tigers do for our kids and community. We embrace the pride of our past and continue to strategically create and foster the future for our kids and families through innovative practices. We have an open and sustained vision that focuses on innovation as the benchmark for our students. Nothing beats public education, and there is no better place to be educated than Howland Local School.
And we're back. Fitch leads the Howland Tigers 40-38 right at the start of the fourth quarter. Big key again. Nathan Barrett's going to have to keep sitting out. When will they put him back in the game? You can't just leave him on the bench forever, as the Tigers need some sort of spark.
Yeah, with fourth fouls, got to be careful, because you could put him in now, but if he gets that fifth one, it won't happen for the end of the game.
With how close this game's been, we might even see some overtime. Get some free basketball.
Howland will get the ball first start this fourth quarter.
Interesting decision here for Fitch to go into the zone, as it was
not
pretty horrible of a decision at the start of the game. The pressure has been great. Oh, those
and double
run a little trap at him. Tomko surprised as it looked like their layback. Jones
and
wide
open for the layup. Tie game.
That's about the easiest layup in Jones' career.
Probably not a soul in sight to guard that one. Howland's going to have to stop Simons in this fourth quarter. He's not in at the moment, but when he comes back in, he's been tough to guard with 20 points.
Fitch now swinging around, nice trying to find some offense.
Drives inside, pass out, open shot.
Nice shot from McKeever. Oh, and just in and out.
Unlucky roll.
Took a little toilet bowl run around the rim.
Vitaly open on the court.